From yesterday's lecture, we summarize that for a solid friction, the applied force is equal to force of static friction. When we say that the body is tends to move, and also we get that the geometrical area is called apparent area. Also we see that when body just move or tends to move, the force of static friction is directly proportional to normal reaction. So therefore we can write the equation for that is mu s is equal to Fs divided by n. It is from the law of static friction. Also we know that the limiting friction, the force of limiting friction, is independent upon the, that is, area which is in contact to the body. So by using this relation, today we want to see the angle of solid friction. Okay, what is the condition for it, or what is the definition for it? The definition for angle of solid friction, I can draw the diagram for it first. So this is the diagram for us. ही एक डायग्राम आहे आपल्याला. इथे या टेबलवरती एक ब्लॉक आपण ठेवतो आहोत. दिस इज अ वन ब्लॉक इन हियर, अँड द फोर्स विच इज ॲक्टिंग ऑन इट इज द वेट, दॅट इज एम जी इन डाऊनवर्ड डायरेक्शन, दॅट इज इक्वल टू वेट, दॅट इज द वेट. अँड द सेकंड फोर्स ॲक्टिंग ऑन दिस इज द नॉर्मल रिॲक्शन. वेन यू अप्लाय द फोर्स ऑफ स्टॅटिक फ्रिक्शन ऑन इट, or sorry, the when we apply the force on this body at the contact in here, the force of static friction is applied in here, and here both of result, here the resultant is in this direction of the normal reaction and the force of static friction, and the angle between this, that is the resultant force and the normal, is called as the angle of solid friction. The definition, I repeat, is that the angle between resultant of contact force or resultant of the contact to the normal reaction is called as angle of solid friction. Now if you see that, again we can draw the figure for it. Again we can write is that here this is the normal reaction, this is the resultant, and we can write the force of friction in here. Theta is the angle in here. So from the figure we can write as the tan theta is equal to, it is Fs divided by n. But from this equation, Fs is equal to mu s into n. So we can write as equation is that tan theta is equal to mu s into n divided by n. So n get cancelled, and therefore we write as tan theta is equal to mu s, or the angle of solid friction, theta is equal to tan inverse mu s. This is the relation for angle of static friction. So this is the derivation, or this is the equation we can got, that is theta is equal to tan inverse mu s. I think that you got it. Now we taking the one question in here. So I draw the figure in here. So this is the figure for us. A sliding is there and block is kept in here. A block or a box is kept in here, like as this. And theta is angle for us. Mu s is the friction in here. Mu s is the static friction in here. And the question is that find out the condition for which block or box is not sliding. This is the question. Find out the condition where the block is not sliding. Now we can know that the forces exert on this block, that is the weight, that is mg in downward direction. Second force which is acting on this, which is perpendicular to the surface, is the normal reaction. Now we can resolve the components of mg, that is the first component of mg in here, that is we write as it is mg cos theta, and second component we write as mg sin theta. These are the two components of the weight, mg cos theta and mg sin theta. As the block is not sliding, the frictional force is exist in here, and the frictional force is Fs in here. Fs is the frictional force. So from the figure, we say that is N is equal to mg cos theta. This is the normal reaction. And the Fs is equal to, and we write as Fs is equal to, that is force of static friction, it is the mg sin theta. These are the two equations. But we know that according to equation of that is the law of solid friction, we know that mu s is equal to Fs divided by N. Therefore Fs is equal to mu s into N. So put the value in here, we write as mu s into N is equal to mg sin theta. But here normal reaction is equal to mg cos theta, and thus we write as the equation as mu s into mg cos theta, it is equal to mg sin theta. And therefore equation we can write as mu s is equal to mg sin theta divided by mg cos theta. And therefore this mg and mg get cancel, and we can write as mu s is equal to tan theta. So when the coefficient of static friction, it is equal to tan theta, or we write as mu s is greater than equal to tan theta, this is the condition where the block is not sliding. So this is our answer. The answer is that if mu s is greater than or equal to tan theta, then the block is not sliding, which is hold at this position. So this is the equation. I think that you can understand what can I show for you. So now we are going to the next point. We are going to the kinetic friction. What is the kinetic friction? When the bodies are sliding on one another, or we say that body is sliding on the another body, the force or the friction are there is called as the kinetic friction. So we want to see the law of kinetic friction. The first law is that of kinetic friction, the force of kinetic friction is directly proportional to normal reaction when the two bodies in contact. This is the first law, that is the force of kinetic friction is directly proportional to the normal reaction. It can be, when the two bodies are in contact, it can be written as Fk is directly proportional to N, and we write as Fk is equal to mu k into N, where we know that mu n is the constant of proportionality, and it is called as mu k, and mu k is known as the coefficient of, it is known as coefficient of kinetic friction, coefficient of kinetic friction. There, this equation can be written as mu k is equal to, it is Fk divided by N, and therefore the coefficient of kinetic friction, it is defined as the ratio of force of kinetic friction to the normal reaction. This is the definition for kinetic friction. I repeat, the definition is that the ratio of force of kinetic friction to the normal reaction when two bodies in contact is called as the, that is the coefficient of kinetic friction. Second law is that, that is the force of kinetic friction is independent on shape and area of body. It is same as the law of static friction, that is the force of kinetic friction is independent on the shape and area of the body. That is the second law. The third law is that, that is the force of kinetic friction is depend upon nature and material of body. And the fourth is that force of kinetic friction is independent on relative velocity of body, provided that relative velocity is not too small and not too large. So these are the laws of kinetic frictions. It can be proved or verified by the experimentally, like as the laws of solid friction. So you can understand, you know the solid laws of how there is a verification of law of solid friction. So same as the laws of kinetic friction can be verified. So we are going to the next point in here.